Oh, I have to say the demo looks fun.
Fuck you. Hey, Capcom's been not too bad recently compared to a lot of companies. They're sure a hell of a lot better than Konami is.
Mm-hmm.
After getting back to the demon statue, I felt a strange premonition and hurried back.
So,
Disco! Dr. Smith, Ryu, the light demon statue was taken! The light demon statue? Yes! Your father and I, we each kept one of the statues, just in case.
Silly.
So that was the two statues. Oh, so that was the two statues would become one. Never mind. The demon's been asleep for 700 years, and now it's starting to wake up. Wake me up inside. Can't wake up. Oh, sorry. We gotta stop it.
After 700 years, I am free to conquer Earth!
You've got to become the Ninja Dragon! Dr. Smith! Dr. Smith! No, you are my favorite character in Lost in Space!
Dr. Zaius? Dr. Zaius?
Come with us. Man, for a ninja, I'm getting like... I don't even know what to say.
That's the third time you've been ambushed.
Welcome, Ryu Hayabusa. We are from the CIA Special Auxiliary Unit. My name's Foster. Australian for beer.
Oh, I thought it was Bananas Foster.
... Getting right to the point. Wait. I want to know why you killed Smith. We can't say his first name seemingly. We did not kill him, but we'll fill you in on what we know.
I mean, you know, that would require the thought that we actually gave a damn about him dying.
In the upper reaches of the Amazon, some ancient ruins were discovered. It seems that the temple was built more than 2,000 years ago. The discoverer was Dr. Smith, who studied the ruins for some time. But one day, he suddenly sealed off the ruins. And ever since then, no one has gone close. Later, however, a man moved in. I think that's a man. It might be a scorpion. I'm not sure. But he calls himself Jukyo. Jukyo. According to our records, it seems that the temple is not where gods are worshipped, but were built to imprison the body of the demon. Therefore, evil spirits are supposed to be held in the statue you have. Dr. Smith probably already knew that.
Yeah, he probably also knew you were an asshole.
He was probably killed by someone working for Jukyo. ... When a black moon shines, light and dark breaks apart. The king of darkness howls. These were the last words written on the stone tablet. If someone brings the demon back to life, he will gain incredible power. Enough to control the entire world. So you knew about this. The woman who shot you in the bar was one of our agents. They are after you. Use this and go to their headquarters. Get the demon statue back from them. We might compensate you. We're the U.S. government. We don't have to do fucking shit if we don't want to. We're going to trust this one ninja. If I say no, you know the answer to that, sir.
Yeah, I'm gonna kick you in the nuts.
Isn't this the intro to, like, Akari Warriors?
No, that was a general note. Just kidding. I don't remember Akari Warriors.
Now we're attacking tarantulas?
Well, you know. How nice of you to go for that swim, Pim. I guess you really need that swim, you know, to cool off.
Guess I just have to jump in. Wow. Okay. Need I point out that despite all the dumb shit Ryu's done, he has still got enough ninja abilities that he just shot three bullets that came out of a machine gun, and he just took out three bullets and the guy shooting a machine gun with his sword. That's pretty impressive.
Very anime of him. That's extremely anime of him.
Well, yeah. Also, kind of impressive. Aw, shit. That was an extra life. I could have used that. Oh, hell yeah. Fuck off, everyone. I'm invincible. And dead! Whoa! Did I fall through the screen a couple times there?
Yeah.
Alright. Just making sure. The sad thing is, Patuk, I actually know the anime. Oh, God damn it. I actually know what. I've seen that, and I know what that came from, and it actually wasn't a ninja. It was a samurai, because it was Goemon from Lupin the Third. But that's beside the point. Oh. Yeah! Extra life.
That's what I've been waiting for. More Lupin.
Lupin is always good.
Yeah. Well, I really enjoyed that last season. Kind of want.
Fuck you all. I'm invincible.
Feel my burn.
Didn't this happen last time? Wasn't that how I died last time?
I think so. At this time, you didn't fall through the screen three times.
That was kind of weird. Oh my god, that wasn't even for anything that great.
Well, now you know to stop going up there. dude, how are you shooting through the environment? I don't understand.
What? That didn't even kill me! Like, I still had health! The bird just fucking somehow completely killed me. That's one hell of a bird.
Well, now you understand why Dr., you know, Eggman wants to lock them up in machines.
Look at that parallax growing.
Why is the rock you're standing on moving? Well, it's sure as hell not Dracula's castle. Although that would be a funny crossover. burst into the castle and run into Simon.
What in the hell is that thing throwing swords at me?
I don't know.
Thank you for that comment, Drax. Drax is referencing one thing that I've multiple times criticized Yahtzee on, which is he said Shovel Knight couldn't be a real Nintendo game because it had parallax scrolling, and I'm like, there's parallax scrolling in Nintendo games? What are you talking about? It's just not as common as, like, in 16-bit games because it was more difficult to program. All right. Though, yes, Fatigue, this game, god damn it. The graphic, this game is really pretty for an old school NES game, and it got two sequels, which are also equally, really nice looking. The third one has really good music, too. Damn it. Because, Ninja Gaiden 3 might be one of my favorite NES soundtracks. That one's really good. Me, you?
Yep.
Okay. You got really quiet, so I was just making sure.
Yeah, I was just looking up. I was just trying to find the names of the enemies.
Are there names for these enemies?
I found a sprite sheet with names on it.
Yep. What?
Biker, knife man, fighter, dog, bat, banshee, runner, gunner.
What is that guy throwing swords?
Jacko Murderer.
Alright. I guess.
That's not the sprite sheet. And apparently the cats we keep seeing on the ground that are hitting us are tigers.
Tigers?
Yeah.
I think they're lacking some things to be tigers. Namely stripes.
Yeah, I was thinking they were more like leopards or something.
I was thinking cougars, but
it looks like they have the spots to us.
I guess it can't be cougars. I mean, I'm sure Ryu's of age. Ha 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 ha.
Apparently the what you called chimpanzees for dogs.
Bullshit. Those do not look like dogs.
Oh, hey, Jason is in the game. It's Mask Killer.
that's pretty accurate. That sounds like what would you say, copyright friendly Jason?
Pretty much. He's even wearing a hockey mask and throwing axes at you. So I say it's pretty much Jason.
Yeah. I mean, that's as Jason as you can get without just straight up saying the name.
Drax linked me to the manual. Let's see if it's different than the sprite sheet I've got.
God damn it. Bitch.
Nah, I can't say if it's different or not. It just shows the boss ones.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. So many birds! So many birds!
But, oh, you better get your hanger ready, Pam, if you're dealing with the birds. Oh, no. They're attacking.
I swear, this game has the worst birds.
I don't know. Those poorly CG animated birds are pretty bad.
Oh, from Birdemic?
Yes.
Okay. That's worse in a completely different way.
Oh, they're gray, so they must be homing pigeons, right?
Oh, yeah, sure. Right. Fuck you, birds. Oh, come on!
Oh god.
I like got something to heal me and then immediately got knocked off a cliff. I can't. Ah! And after I passed the freaking bird spot. I do wonder what was it that when we were kids we had so much more patience for video game bullshit than we do now.
We didn't know better.
I guess that's fair.
I mean, compared to the Atari, you know, this was a lot, but it was better. It was easier to put up this than to set up the Atari.
I don't know. I don't think anything on the Atari pissed me off as much as, freaking Battletoads.
Yeah, one of my other artist friends is like, Battletoads is a good game. I'm like,
no, it's not.
What? No.
A lot of people like believe that. I mean, me and Crunchy have arguments on that sometimes.
Yeah. Especially that one stage. Oh God, I hate that stage.
I hate a lot of stages in that game.
I can put up with most of the stages, but that stage is horrible.
But, anyways. Maybe someday I'll try to brute force that game. Maybe.
Don't kill yourself, though.
Let's see how this goes first. I don't know if I can deal with being as infuriated with, like, I don't know. I did pretty good in a 3D World Runner, even though I didn't beat that.
Max says he'd rather see you play Super Battletoads Double Dragon.
Oh, that's definitely a... Does he mean Battletoads and Double Dragon? Because Super Battletoads is a different game.
This is Drax we're talking about. You know how he gets mixed things mixed up.
I mean, that's definitely a... better game than, normal Battletoads, that's for sure.
Yeah, I don't think that blue thing is a dog like it says. It looks nothing like a dog.
It's like a chimpanzee wearing an outfit. Oh, hey! Jason! Bye! I like these guys doing random spin kicks.
I don't know.
Ooh. Hello. Hello, my favorite weapon in this game.
He's that apparently, according to the sprite sheet, they're martial artists. Yeah, he meant Battletoads Double Dragon.
Yeah, I figured.
I figured you figured, but he just wanted me to clarify.
Well, if there's any Battletoads game I'd play, it'd probably be that one or maybe the arcade one. But I'm sure not going to play the NES one anytime soon. Oh, then again, I don't know.
Depends on your mood.
Yeah.
And one of my other Discord servers I'm in, you know, we were talking about the price of Nintendo games. And I'm like, yeah, I'm kind of annoyed with them right now. It's like, why is that? Well, let's see, I bought Octopath Traveler, and then yesterday, then the other day, it goes on sale for 50% off. Like, that's just a dick move, man. Jack says he'd also like to see you play Super Battletoads.
Yeah, Super Battletoads is the name of the arcade one, which is actually pretty decent.
Well, of course, it was arcade. Most things arcade are fun. Reminds me, we need to get Fightcade so we can do Kid Ash sometime.
That is true. I just need to get off my ass and do that.
I still want to play that multiplayer.
Okay.
It's one of those games I remember playing, and I remember coming across only in one ever arcade, but I remember enjoying it.
Yeah, they actually had it at my local arcade in Ardmore. With how much I get pestered by Kyo to, like, update Fightcade, you'd think I'd done it by now.
You got other things on your mind most of the time.
Well, that's true. I do need to do it, though, because that would be fun. Because that would actually open up for a lot of multiplayer streams. Oh, come on, just one more hit. Yeah! Fuck that gremlin bitch! Beat you down, beat you. What the fuck is this motherfucker? You wanna voice this guy?
I don't know, I'm not there yet.
Oh.
You still have the gremlins for me.
Then, shoot.
Is it another boss?
Oh. Well, I guess I'll just do it. Ryu! Ryu! You! You coward! No, don't give it to him! Don't give him the deed! Now put down the demon statue on the floor and back up! Nice work! I guess this is goodbye! Have a nice day. I couldn't decide what voice to give him.
Weird guy is Guardia de Muse.
Take the girl away.
or as the manual says, he also calls himself Jocchio.
Yeah, Jocchio. I mean, what is he? I mean, it's like I see a face, but I don't know what the rest of this stuff around him is. It looks like he's covered in ropes. It's like he does.
He's Shrek's dad.
Get out of my swamp! Alright. I'm gonna do... Oh no, because if I do the screen share, you'll have problem light.
That's okay, give me a minute. I was cut up there because I had to refresh the stream, but I accidentally closed the window, so give me a minute.
I was like... Yeah, because I was thinking maybe I should do a stream share so, like, I can have you voice the villain, but then you'll have more trouble, like, keeping up with the chat. So, nah, I'll just come up with a voice for the villain. It'll be fine. Just don't know what.
I have to see this stream again.
Because unfortunately, this isn't one of those cases where I can just, like, it doesn't hold the text there until I press B or something. It'll leave on its own.
Yeah. I'm more concerned about the alien corpses attached to the wall in the background.
Well, someone in the design area definitely liked H.R. Geiger, for lack of better words. Oh, they're back! The birds are back! Did that guy just bowl an axe at me?
Let's see, what's his name? Guillotine Man.
I don't think that's a guillotine.
I'm not sure whoever translated this knew what the hell they were talking about. I think they just picked random names for shit.
I think they're just like, that looks like that, right?
I think it was more like, we're on a crunch time. I don't want to be here all night. Let's just name it something. That's a dog. There we go. We're done.
Son of a bitch. That's evil. Oh, shoot. I need to say.
Well, it was a bat, so.
He is the knight.
I was going to say, you know, it is a bat, so it must have been Dracula.
Drac is back.
In town.
That's going to happen when they try to make a hip Dracula movie. They're like, Drac is back!
And then they play the Boys Are Back song.
Well, that was how they advertised that Pac-Man cartoon. Like, Pac-Man and the Ghostly Adventures was it? They're like, Pac is back.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, I'll watch the cartoon.
I was like, really? That's what you're going for? I'm like, that's what you're gonna go with. That's a tagline I don't think has been used since like the 90s. That's right, Patuk. Meme Pac-Man. Oh no, I've been turned into a meme! Or whatever that line was.
Still beats the whole, I have control over the forest. I'll just whistle at the trees and they'll move.
God, the Hanna-Barbera. The Hanna-Barbera Pac-Man show is a shit show. I do kind of love it, though, because it's just, like, what the hell? Oh, yeah, there's the right line. Aw, man, I'm a meme. Oh, yeah, that's right, when we played the Pac-Man The Ghostly Adventures game, Batuu kept calling Pac-Man Teeth Man.